Welcome back to my channel, everyone. My name is Elise, for those of you that are new, and if you are a returning subscriber, what is up? So in today's video, we are gonna go over this makeup look. It's an early 2000s makeup look. I already did my hair, as you can see. It's like a, I don't know what you call it, part hair, and like a parted hairstyle, and I teased it from the back to give it that like volume, and I also added some like little clips. And yeah, if you're interested in finding out how I achieved this look, then keep watching this video. We are going to do a tutorial. We're gonna do our makeup today, okay? It's the weekend and we're just gonna get cute. And yeah, anyway, I am gonna go ahead and do a... I used to love this look back in high school when I was like 13, 14. I would do my, even when I was like 10, like this was the look, this was my go-to look. My mom, I think she like hated it. I remember being in class senior year, like 2008, 2007, and my friend would always be like, dude, you need to chill on the teasing and the hairspray. And I was just like, what do you know about style? Mentioned, if you guys want a tutorial on this hair look, let me know. I am the tease queen. I was the tease queen. We're gonna start with foundation. I already prepped my face, I already put moisturizer, all that jazz. So I'm gonna go in with the MAC Studio Fix foundation in the color NC35. You all know what this looks like. And I'm gonna apply my foundation, oh shit, with the Kabuki 182S brush. I remember back in the day, contouring and stuff wasn't really like popular. It wasn't like the it thing. It was more like natural, you know? And the thinner eyebrows. I remember in high school, let me take you guys back to a year, 2004 or five. I was in high school. I think I was like 14 or 15. Girl, my eyebrows were disgusting. They were so thin. This order I placed from CB2, girl, when I came home to try to pick it up, it was not here. And I was like, oh my god, somebody took it. Like, I have a feeling it was one of the neighbors. Like, I just have a feeling, aka the one next door to me. The fucking one that I can't stand. So I called CB2 and I reordered it. And they were so nice to send me a new one. And I finally got it, I think yesterday. And I was so excited. I was super excited when I first placed the order because it's one of those little oil elixir stuff. I don't know. I was gonna use it for mouthwash. Anyway, long story short, the neighbor comes in. Like literally 5 minutes before I start filming, and she's like, I accidentally took your package. And I was just thinking to myself, like, accidentally, my name is on the front of the box. And where you have to open it, clearly says my name. So I just don't understand. I'm going to fill in my brows. So unfortunately, my eyebrows are not 2000 vibes. They're more like today vibes. Roll out. I used to wear so much makeup that when people would come and give, like, foundation, that when people would come and give me a hug, it would get on their shirt. I made you a celebrity overnight. Girl, I see you in the back of bottom jeans. Chinchilla on your back, I wanna know your name. Girl, I'm just out to blow your brains. Put you in the chameleon. My brows are done. I'm gonna go in and prime my lid. Okay, so if you're like an OG MAC person, you know that these paint pots were like the shit back then. So I'm gonna use the soft ochre paint pot. So I'm gonna use the brush to just apply my corners and then blend it with my finger. Then I'm gonna go in with like a pink shadow. I don't have the name of this shadow. Like pinky color here and this one. My shit is so fucked up. Sorry, not sorry. The Morphe Artistry palette. It's so messed up. And I'm gonna use the colors Three Little Words and Lust. So this one and this one. And I'm just gonna mix it to give it like the shimmery, that shimmer, that 2000s shimmer. Right now, so baby, kiss me through the phone. Kiss me through the phone. Avon had all the creamy colored eyeshadows. I don't think my mom was into MAC. I don't think she could afford it. She used like drugstore makeup and I used drugstore makeup, so that's what happened. Now this is a Morphe blending brush. I don't even know the number. It's like faded away. This is what it looks like. And I'm gonna take this light like pink color. I don't know what the name of it is. And I am gonna pack it on here and blend. Hopefully I don't fuck up my makeup. And I'm just gonna blend it. Yeah, no fear. Write me a letter. Till then, I walk it out, I walk it out. I think I'm gonna add like a mauve to the corners. So I'm gonna go back to the Artistry palette and use the color Risque, and it looks like this one right here. Wait, is it this one? Yeah, this one right here. Darken the corners up a little bit. And add like a little contrast. That bomb shit. Y'all niggas know all day we be making a drop. Y'all niggas know every time we come through this motherfucker, we be always taking a ride. So let me go. I'm gonna add a little bit of shimmer to the inner corners of my eyes. So I'm gonna take this Morphe Daisy Danger, I think it is. Yeah, Daisy Danger highlighter in the color Illuminor. I don't know. Anyway, I'm just gonna add that to the corner of my eye. I know what them girls, I know what they feel, cause I'm breathing on their heels, and it's me they wanna kill. My makeup, it's just pretty much how I'm feeling. Usually I'll do foundation then concealer because I don't really do eyeshadow. I just like kind of go over it with like whatever neutral brown, but since I'm really doing my eyeshadow, I'll do my concealer after eyeshadow, which is probably bad, but whatever. So I'm just gonna go here, and if I'm applying this wrong, do not come for me, please. I don't even think they used concealer back in the 2000s, but we're doing 2000s with like a spin. Always surrounded by so many. I'm a gigolo, always on the go. Every time I turn around, I got another show. I use the Milk Makeup Concealer. It's the Flex Concealer in the color Light. I use the lightest color because I want that extra highlight, you know? Extra. Highlight, extra yellow, extra, extra, extra. I'm gonna set my under eyes with the Hourglass Bale Translucent Powder. This is so good. This is my favorite.
sexy style. Love it when you're getting wild. Girl in the club with me.
So that's done. I don't usually contour. I've never contoured my nose. Like I gave up. When contouring came into style, I was like, oh my God, I can't do this, because no matter how much I contour my nose, it's not gonna help. But now that I got my nose done, I feel like I can contour my nose. And I even went and bought a brush to contour my nose. I got this at the 99 cent store, by the way. What brand is it? No brand, but we're gonna try to contour my nose today. Just literally use bronzer and that's it. I don't use creams, none of that. Because again, I'm not really into contouring. And I probably did this backwards, but we're just gonna do what we do today, okay? It's my first makeup tutorial, so I'm like really... This isn't even a tutorial, it's a... I don't know, I guess it is. I'm trying, guys. Right. Now that that's done, I am gonna contour my nose. I'm gonna attempt to contour my nose for the very first time. Ladies and gentlemen, this is worldwide premiere. Contouring my nose. God, pray to God this comes out good. So I'm gonna use this brush from the 99 cent store, and I'm gonna use the Hoola bronzer in the color, is this color? No, the Hoola Benefit bronzer, you guys know what that is. So I'm just gonna grab it and start from here and down, girl. I might be onto something. This is legit the first time I've contoured my nose since I got it done. And the journey to get here, like to actually feel comfortable wearing makeup and actually feel cute after a nose job, has been so crazy. Like, I watch old videos from like 2 months post-op and I'm just like, girl, what were you thinking? My nose looked really bad. And now I know like why people really coming for me. But then again, I'm just like, dude, don't come for me. Like, I'm literally 2 months post-op. Like, my shit is not gonna be spectacular like some people. Everyone's different, you know? So it's just dear, dear.
Come on, baby, turn around and see the sexy body go.
Alright, now that that's done, I am going to bronze my face with the Hoola bronzer. I'm gonna use this angled brush that came with the Lorac palette. It was a Lorac bronzing palette. And I just bronze. I don't have a specific way of bronzing. I just go with it.
It's crazy, but baby, I
love it when I'm with you, baby.
Girl, your stare, those eyes.
All right, you guys, we're really on to something here. Now that that's done, I'm gonna apply my lashes.
Cash my thing, I thought everything away. There goes the dream.
It is so complicated to get like the lash on right. I suck at liquid liner. I used to be so good at it back in the 2000s. So I like to stick to like eyeshadow because it's easier to maneuver and work with. I've been practicing with liquid eyeliner, but for the sake of this video, I'm not gonna do it today. I'm just gonna use my shadow. So from that same Morphe palette, I'm gonna use the color Little Black Book, and I'm gonna use this angled brush from Jane Iredell angle liner brow. I got this at a beauty salon. But I'm not a beauty guru. I'm not a beauty expert. I'm just a me. Now, I am going to take this off. With this Eco Tools Kabuki brush. Oh, I got it at Marshall's. Marshall's really has some good makeup stuff. I'm gonna set my face with powder. I'm gonna use a Maybelline Super Stay Full Coverage Powder in the color Golden Doré. This is what it looks like. I just like to pick a little bit. Just to touch up like my oil areas. For blush, I'm gonna use this Tarte Partay blush. This is old. I got it from Sephora, one of those birthday things. It works. It works for me. So I'm gonna apply it on the apples of my cheeks. Kid, I love my life and my public. Put God first and can't forget to stay real. I also like to put a little bit on my nose, some right here. Put on some mascara. I'm using the NARS Climax mascara. This is a travel size. A lot of my makeup, or most, sometimes I like to get stuff in travel size because I don't wear makeup on the daily, so I don't run out as fast as some people. So travel size really does the trick for me. And yeah. I'm gonna use the Lasting Sensation Lip Liner by MAC. This is what this looks like. This is the color. It's like a pretty orangey color. You getting money, homie? Show me if it's like that. Some lipstick. I'm gonna take MAC Please Me Remember. You guys, do you guys remember Please Me? This is what it looks like. Yes, I know you guys all remember it. So I am gonna use a concealer brush. This is the MAC 242 brush, and I'm just gonna take some off of here and use it on my lips. I'm just gonna add some gloss to my lips because you know gloss was popping. Gloss, it used to be all about the glosses back then. So I'm gonna take this Kopari lip glossy. This is what it looks like. This is just a lip balm and I like it because it glosses my lips. Voila. I'm going to go in with this Anastasia brow gel and I'm just gonna clean up my brows or brush my brows so these furry babies can stay in place, because you guys, my eyebrows are fucking insane. They literally look like barbed wire sometimes. I'm also gonna add some pink under my eyes. And that sums up the look. Let me show you that I feel you. Wanna freak, wanna ride with you. Wanna taste, wanna put my lips all over you. Thank you so much for tuning in. Let me know if you liked this video, and if you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Leave me a comment. Let me know what you think. What are your most memorable early 2000s memories? Comment, show me some love if you're interested in watching more of my videos. I mean, you want to watch more videos like this, let me know, and also subscribe to my channel. It will really help me out a lot. And until the next video, thank you. Love you. I like that. I like that. Girl, what that. Oh, I like that.